And we're back with some welterweight action. Mick Broster being called here by Mark Goddard and Ross the Boss Mason. His hometown of Birmingham, and he's going to be taking on Nigel Heatier, another local favourite.
And his opponent, entering into the blue corner, let's hear it for Nigel Heatier.
I've seen Mick Broster fight before. I think he's got good jiu-jitsu.
Yep.
He doesn't really like to stand up. I think Nigel is less experienced but more of an all-rounder. So it could be an interesting match.
I think both fighters have suffered from in the past. It's some awful matchups. Matched up against guys way above their level. And that's why I think this is going to be interesting. Two guys evenly matched. Should be interesting what happens. Last time out, FX3, Whittier lost to Paul Kelly of the Wolf Slam, middleweight.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the fighter standing to my right in the red corner. He hails from Birmingham. He's 38 years old. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall and weighing in at 76.8 kilos. He fights for the Tap Out Academy. And he has a mixed martial arts record of 5 contests, 2 wins and 3 losses. Let's hear it for Mick Broster. And the fighter standing to my left, in the blue corner, he hails from Bradford. He's 26 years old. He stands 5 feet, 8 inches tall, and 377 kilos exactly. He fights for the CT Fight School and the FX3 team. He has a mixed martial arts record of 9 contests, 4 wins and 5 losses. Let's hear it for Nigel Pitbull.
Both men getting last minute instructions from referee Grant Waterman. And I don't know, Lee, I think this is going to be another close fight. You know, neither fighter really stands out for me as being the more dominant fighter.
Yeah, I think Mick's definitely got an advantage on the ground, with Nigel being better on the feet. Nigel's more well-rounded. If it goes to the ground, Nigel might be able to survive, but if it stays on the feet, I think Nigel will knock him out.
Okay.
So I think Mick's going to have to get to the ground for sure.
Mick Broster.
Oh, he's throwing.
Yeah. And he gets a takedown. Training with Ross Mason, though, is obviously going to help you stand up.
Yeah, of course. And he's training with Mark Goddard.
And that's going to help your groundwork as well.
Well, they've got a really good camp up there.
And I think Mick Broster took Paul Jenkins 2 or 3 rounds earlier this year. So, I mean, that was his first fight back for 2 years. So, you know, even though he's 38, you know, Mick's on the comeback trail. Let's see what he can do.
Oh, he goes straight to mount. He's definitely more comfortable on the ground.
Oh, yeah, without a doubt. Whittier just trying to basically force Broster out of this position, but I don't think it's going to happen.
No, I don't even know why. I think he's
giving an armbar.
And Nigel gets out.
Credit to Nigel for that. He had a good escape out of that one. Oh, an axe kick. And he's caught Broster in the face, round the eye, Lee.
Yeah. And now, referee's called timeout.
Now that's an illegal move, isn't it, in professional MMA in this country?
I think you can axe kick to the
but
body.
But not to the head.
I'm not sure.
And I think it was an axe kick to the body, which just landed on the head. I think it was an accidental blow.
Yeah, I think he's aiming for the body.
But Boston moved.
Possibly sat up into it.
Yeah. I think it'll be harsh if Whitney loses a point out of this, but he'll get 5 minutes to recover. And the medic's coming in to check. Ross has definitely been caught in the eye socket.
Yeah, but I think he's having trouble seeing, I think. Waved off.
So no contest, surely, now?
I'm not sure.
Are they going to disqualify with you, are they?
They might do.
Grant Waterman? And Grant Waterman has just said this is going to be a DQ.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, after 1 minute and 41 seconds in the first round, due to an illegal blow, as a kick to the head by the opponent, unfortunately, Nigel Ridge has been disqualified. So the fight is your winner, Mick Brosta.
Yep, so it's a disqualification then.
An unpopular decision, but Grant Waterman, that's how he called it. And
okay, looks like both guys are going to do this again.